Neha Pariyani. In today's session, we are going to discuss about accounting conventions. So let's get started.
Accounting conventions. Accounting conventions are the customs and traditions which are followed by the accountants as a guide in preparation of financial statements of a business concern. Right? So accountants, while preparing the financial statements of business, they have to follow these customs and traditions. Right? So we know the meaning of accounting concepts, right? They are the assumptions that are made while preparing the financial statements. And in the same way, accounting conventions are the customs and traditions, right? So they are like rules which are need to be followed by accountants, and they serves as guide. They help in preparation of financial statements, right? So there are four accounting conventions. They are Convention of Conservatism or Prudence Convention, Convention of Consistency, Convention of Full Disclosure, Convention of Materiality. So let's try to understand them in detail. First is Convention of Conservatism, also known as Prudence Convention. Okay, according to this convention, a safe policy is adopted in preparing the financial statements of a concern. Right? So this convention is like playing a safe game. It takes various precautionary measures. Right? It means that anticipated profits are ignored. Anticipated profits are ignored, whereas anticipated losses are considered. Okay? While preparing financial statements. So here it says that whatever the possible profits can arise in the business organization, they needs to be ignored, because profits may arise or may not arise, right? So they won't affect our business organization. But what if losses arise? The business has to be ready to face the losses, right? Hence we need to anticipate all the possible losses while preparing the financial statements, right? While preparing the financial statements like profit and loss account and balance sheet, we consider bad debts, right? Or we make certain provisions and reserves for bad debts, right? So it is because if in case bad debts arises, that is loss arises, we have to be ready to face the losses. Okay? Next convention is Convention of Consistency. According to this convention, financial statements should be prepared on the same basis as that of preceding period. So we know that the accounting financial statements of a business concern are prepared for different accounting periods, right? So accounting period is generally of 12 months. Okay, so the methods or policies or procedures that are followed by the business while preparing the statement in the preceding year, that is previous year, has to be followed in the next year as well. So there has to be consistency in preparation of financial statements. The methods, policies and standards, procedures, etc. Whatever used in the previous year should be continued in the next year as well. Right? So whatever may be the accounting policies, methods once decided, these are to be followed consistently. So it does not mean that we cannot change them. Right? But there has to be no intention to change. Frequently the changes should not be made. But if in case any situation arises and we need to change them, then we have to report it. Right? So we have to disclose that matter to our investors, shareholders, etc. Okay? Next, Convention of Full Disclosure. According to this convention, all the important information should be fully disclosed in the financial statements of a concern. So we know that there are many users of financial statements of a business, right? So users of financial statements are like shareholders, investors and creditors, customers, even government. They use the financial statements to know the financial position of the business, right? Hence this convention says that it is very important to disclose full information or complete information relating to business in the financial statements, right? The information to be disclosed may relate to current accounting period, previous period, or post balance sheet date. So it is not necessary that the information has to be relating to current accounting period only. So information may be either for current period or previous or even future, right? So whatever it is important, if it is important, it has to be disclosed. Okay, the last convention is convention of materiality. The materiality principle is an exception to the full disclosure. So this is an exception to full disclosure convention. Okay, according to this convention, only the significant information which is material, right, so which is material in nature, is disclosed in the financial statement. As per convention of full disclosure, the information which is important should be fully disclosed in the financial statements, right? But whereas convention of materiality says that only the information which is significant or which is material in nature has to be disclosed, right? So how will you decide which information is material in nature, or what is this term called material information, right? So the answer is any information which has an impact on the decision of shareholders, investors or any other users of information, that we treat it as material information. Okay, so in order to minimize the cost, what accountant does is he reports only material information. He eliminates all the insignificant or all immaterial information, and only he refines all the information, and only material information is disclosed in the books of accounts or financial statements of a business concern, right? So these were few accounting conventions, or you can also call it as customs and traditions, which are followed by accountants while preparing the financial statements of a business concern.
If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.